William Rhody Bryan Jr., the man who recorded the fatal shooting of Ahmaud Arbery in a neighborhood outside Brunswick, Georgia, has been arrested on suspicion of murder, the Georgia Bureau of Investigation said Thursday. Bryan witnessed the deadly encounter between Travis McMichael and Ahmaud Arbery on February 23rd from a vehicle behind a pickup that stopped in the road. Gregory Michael, who was in the bed of the pickup during the shooting, told police that Bryan had tried to help them stop Arbery earlier. Kevin Goff, an attorney for Bryan, said Monday that Bryan had taken a polygraph test that confirmed he was not involved in the shooting. Bryan was unarmed at the time of the shooting, and Bryan did not have any conversations with Gregory or Travis McMichael before the shooting, Goff said, citing test results. Bryan took the test voluntarily, said a Goff, who referred to his client as the state's star witness. The GBI, which is conducting the investigation into Ahmaud Arbery's death, said Bryan, age 50, was arrested Thursday and will face charges of felony murder and criminal attempt to commit false imprisonment. Bryan will be booked into the Glynn County Jail, where the McMichaels are being held on charges of murder and aggravated assault. The father and son's legal teams have said that full details of the case haven't made it into the public arena, and they've promised the truth will exonerate their clients. CNN attempted to reach out to attorney Goff on Thursday evening. The video Bryan recorded on his cell phone shows Ahmaud Arbery trying to run around the McMichaels' truck before turning sharply towards Travis McMichael and tussling over his gun. Ahmaud Arbery was shot 3 times and collapsed in the street. The 36-second video was not released until more than 10 weeks after the killing and spurred calls for the McMichaels' arrest. It does not show what led up to the final moments of Ahmaud Arbery's life. Gregory McMichael, a former prosecutorial investigator, ex-Glynn County police officer, and Travis's father, told police that he and his son chased Ahmaud Arbery after seeing him at a neighbor's house under construction. They suspected him in a rash of break-ins, according to an incident report. McMichael told police his son had tried to cut off Arbery with his truck, but Ahmaud Arbery turned around. McMichael stated the unidentified male turned around and began running back the direction from which he came, and Rhody attempted to block him in, which was unsuccessful, the police report says. Goff said that Bryan was a witness and not a vigilante. He told CNN last week that Bryan was working in his yard when he saw a person he did not know being chased by a vehicle he recognized from the neighborhood. Attorneys representing members of the Arbery family said they were relieved. We called for his arrest from the very beginning of this process, says the family's attorney S. Lee Merritt, Benjamin Crump, and L. Chris Stewart. His involvement in the murder of Mr. Arbery was obvious to us and to many around the country, and after their thorough investigation, it was clear to the GBI as well. They thank the GBI for its diligence. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm so glad they arrested this Bryan guy. Now they need to arrest Travis McMichael's sister for posting pictures of Ahmaud's body on Snapchat. That is so vile and so disgusting. She must have no morals or integrity. The nerve of her to post pictures of Ahmaud's body after her father and her brother gunned him down.